Good morning, students. Today, let me start new chapter, Transformer. This particular chapter consists all the following points: definition, principle of operation, types of transformer, EMF equation of transformer, turns ratio, numericals, losses in transformer, efficiency of transformer, voltage regulation and transformer, and application of transformer. Now, this particular video which I am capturing today, which covers only our transformer syllabus. Let me begin with the topics. So before going with actual concept, let me show you the transformer symbolic representation. Here totally three symbolic representation I am showing here. First one is 1:1 ratio transformer. Here number of windings in the primary side as well as in the secondary sides are same, hence it is called 1:1 ratio transformer. And this one is here in the primary side, number of windings are more than the secondary winding, hence the voltage induced in the secondary winding will be lesser than the primary winding, hence it is called a step down transformer. And third one is here, number of windings in the secondary side is more than the primary winding, hence it is called a step up transformer. Now, as you know, this is the winding symbol, and here in between this two straight line what we have shown in all the diagram, it is nothing but it is represents the core of the transformer, which is represents the core of the transformer. Now let me show you the constructional diagram of the transformer. This particular rectangular portion is called a core, and this core has one window on both the limbs. This vertical portion is called a limb, and this horizontal portion is called yoke, and together it is called core. On this both the limbs, the winding has wound, and now the winding which is connected to the source is called primary winding. The winding which is connected to the load is called the secondary winding. Now the notations which we have used here, it is written on this actually, where V1 represents the source voltage, I1 represents the primary current, E1 represents the EMF induced in the primary, N1 is nothing but number of turns in the primary, N2 is a number of turns in the secondary, E5 stands for the flux in the core, E2 stands for the EMF induced in the secondary winding, I2 which is the secondary current which flows only when the load is connected across the secondary winding, and V2 represents the terminal voltage. This is the basic concept of the transformer which is required before going through the full concept. Now let me start with the topic concepts here. Let us understand what is the transformer, or you can try to understand the definition of transformer. See here, transformer can be defined, it is a static electrical apparatus which transfer power from one electrical circuit to the another electrical circuit without any electrical connection, with a desirable change in the voltage and current by keeping frequency constant. In this particular definitions, we need to concentrate on particularly four words. That is, one is static, another one is which transfers the power, and without any connection in the electrical circuits, only if it changes the desirable change in the voltage as well as the current and keeping the constant frequency constant, desirable change in the voltage and current, static piece of apparatus and transfer the electrical power. These are the main things which we need to concentrate. Let us try to understand what exactly. A transformer is a static piece. Why they are calling it is a static piece? Because comparing with the generator and motor, there is no rotating parts. Hence, it is called static piece of apparatus, or it is called a static electrical device. Now, what it does, which transfers the power from one electrical circuit to the another electrical circuit. That means the power which transfers from this electrical circuit to this electrical circuit without any connection between these two electrical circuit. There is no electrical connection, but there is a magnetic connection or magnetic link is available between these two windings. Now this transformer transfers this power E into I and to the power to the secondary winding, that is E2 into I2, with desirable change in the voltage and current. It says that the transformer which can increase the voltage, this primary voltage to the secondary voltage, or this voltage can be reduced at the secondary, but during this process the current may decrease or increase, as this current is always inversely proportional to the this voltages. The reason behind this is the turns ratio, that we are going to see that justification while explaining the turns ratio. And right now what we need to understand is desirable change in the voltage and current is nothing but if you want to increase the voltage can be raised, that time current will be decreased, or voltage can be decreased, that time current can be increased. That is what it is here written, along with the vice versa of current. This is the definition of the transformer. Now let us try to understand the principal operation of transformer. Basically, transformer works on the principle of mutual induction. Now what is mutual induction? How do we define that mutual induction? Mutual induction states that there is a uniform change in the current in one coil which induces the EMF in the same as well as the other coil is called the mutual induction procedure. Now let us try to understand this operation or principle of operation with help of this diagram. Here we are applying sinusoidal AC voltage. As this sinusoidal voltage you are applying here, whatever current I1 we have written, this is nothing but sinusoidal AC current. This AC current changes its value with respect to time, so that there is a uniform change in this current induces the flux in this particular core, and this flux links with the same winding as well as this same flux links with the other winding. Hence the flux linking with the conductor is changing in this coil, which induces the EMF E1 as per the Faraday's laws of electromagnetic induction. And that same flux is also linking with the other coil, and which that flux is also changing with respect to, which is changing with respect to time. Hence it induces the EMF E2. If this winding is connected to the load, then definitely current I2 starts flowing through this load. If this load is not connected, and if this winding is kept open, and during this open condition current I2 becomes zero, EMF will induce, but it will not circulate any current in this circuit. As that circuit is open, current I2 becomes zero. That is the meaning of the mutual induction. If somebody asks that question, write the principal operation of a single phase transformer, then you can explain the principle of mutual induction, and that mutual induction principle is nothing but this one only. Now if instead of connecting AC supply or AC source to the transformer, if we connect a DC source to this particular device, then what happens? That is the question comes into the picture. Otherwise, whether transformer works on DC supply instead of AC supply, the answer for this question is no. The transformer will not work on the DC supply, because in DC direct current, the current value does not change with respect to time. Hence, there is no uniform change in the current. That is what the basic requirement for the transformer to operate, and that is not happening. Hence, because of that reason, transformer doesn't work if you provide the DC supply. But the question is, what happens if DC supply is given to this transformer? As in the DC, frequency component is zero, so inductive reactance offered by this winding is zero, because XL is equal to 2 pi FL. As F is zero, so XL is zero. So hence, in this winding, the opposition component offered by this winding is only resistance, in as inductive reactance XL is zero. As we all know, the copper conductor, whatever we use, the resistance we keep or we choose is very small. As the resistance is very small, the current drawn by this winding, I is equal to V by Z, and that Z is nothing but, now it is in this case, is only R. So I is equal to V by R. So R is very, very small. Hence, current drawn by this winding is very high, which damages the winding of the transformer. Hence, transformer cannot be operated with the DC supply. Now let us move to the next topic in this particular chapter, that is main parts of the transformer. As if you consider distribution transformer, there are many parts are available, but at the elementary level, the transformer consists basically two parts, which are transformer core and transformer winding. Now let us try to understand what is core. Core is a solid piece of material which is made up of iron earlier days, and nowadays which is made up of high grade silicon steel, which is made up of thin lamination instead of solid material. The reason behind it will be explained in the next videos. Now the function of this core is, which supports the winding to get wound on it, as well as it provides the magnetic path for the flowing of flux. You can just refer to the this diagram. In this this is nothing but core, and in this core, that on the limb winding is wound, and this particular winding, when the current carry flows through this winding, which produces the flux, and that this flux will flow through this path only. Hence, it produces the path, that is what low reluctance path will be provided by this particular core. That is the function of the core. And if you look at the winding function, which carries the electric current and produces the magnetic flux in it, which is the responsible for inducing EMF in it. So the winding is the other main important part. This winding carries the current, and when this is carrying the current, then definitely which produces the magnetic flux, and that flux is the responsible for this EMF as well as the primary EMF. So these are the function of core as well as the winding, and usually winding will be made up of using the copper. Now we can look at the types of transformer. This transformer can be classified based on the various factors, and those are written on here. Based on the construction, it can be classified. Based on the voltage levels, it can be classified. Based on the phase, based on the application, some other factor also are available, but right now we are concentrating on these particular factors. Particularly, Based on the construction, again it is divided into two types. One is core type and shell type. Based on the voltage level, step up transformer, step down transformer, and 1:1 ratio transformer, and it is also called isolation transformer. Third one is the based on the phase. It is single phase and three phase transformer. And fourth one is the based on the applications, and here it is divided into, or it is classified into, distribution transformer, instrument transformer, auto transformer, resonant transformer, power transformer, etc. Now for our portion, we are going to study the transformer based on the construction, that is core type and shell type transformer we are going to study, as well as based on the voltage level, step up, step down, and 1:1 ratio transformer also we are going to see. Along with that, based on the phases, single phase transformer we are going to study as per your syllabus is concerned. Now in the next video, let us try to explain the based on the constructions, how that transformer works and which all transformers are there, in the next class. Thank you.